Welcome back from that short break. We are talking what is failing the political parties here in Uganda and what can be done to strengthen them. Timothy, you have heard the FDC leaders trading accusations against one another about them being moles and all these other questions of accountability about money received within the party. What do you think about the FDC generally?
So first, I think that to discuss the question of political parties, you have to look at it from the political dispensation and the political wave which we are in, because it informs how politics, how the political parties, and how the question of politics in country is conducted, because that largely informs the question of democracy, the question of governance in the country. And as Doctor says, the political parties contribute towards the growth of the democracy in any country. And when they fail, then we have to ask ourselves why. And who is this failure benefiting? Definitely there has to be someone benefiting directly. Or it will be a person, it will be a group of them benefiting directly on the on the non-operationalization of some of these institutions. But definitely there has to be truth somewhere. When accusations are thrown right, left and center, there's truth. There's usually no smoke without fire. And that speaks to the question that while the question of disagreements here and there within political parties is healthy, the interference of their operation is something that we've seen in the past. And this is not the first time we're having this conversation. And as Doctor mentions, it's something that has come time immemorial, where political parties interfered with either directly or through individuals to ensure that it serves a specific individual. So you've seen others being bought, others. But definitely that means that it's a test of our institutions. It's a test of how we operate. And I think that FDC equally, again, is in a space where its capacity to operate, to address its questions internally, is at stake. How they come out as a result of these questions, I think it's something we are waiting to see. But definitely, it's in a space where there is a bit of more confusion. And so I think that the FDC, within the political, within the larger context, is a political party that has a lot of interest. Looking at it from my perspective, I see that the opposition question still is an aspect that is in question. We've seen the entrance of the NUP, which is currently the leading opposition party, and you'll definitely look at the interests that are involved, at least from the political, the ruling party. So you have the ruling party, you have the disorganization and the interest involved within the opposition. So definitely you will realize that when the opposition are disorganized, when the political parties are not operational, when the people are fighting, there is someone somewhere who is benefiting. And so I think the ultimate question we have to find ourselves is, to what end and how can we strengthen these political parties? And that speaks to the question of environment, that speaks to the question of our legal systems, but also the establishment of some of these political parties. Of course, some of them are established as a result of WEV, and FDC is not one of them. If you look at them, you definitely see that there seem to have been a very, very clear objective that the original people who came around that had a very clear vision which to achieve. However, I think that we've reached at a point where interests are cutting, especially from the upcoming leadership and those that are founders, those who seem to hold. And so when you see there's a bit of back and forth accusations, there's definitely an upper hand that can be seen from very far.
Mm. I have a question on that, but just before I ask that question, to ask Dr. Matembe here, do you think that the FDC is still on course? And as a senior politician who is also founder of this party, where do you think this party went off track?
But you know, for me, you said you would ask us later. But as a person who has been in this country for long, I mean, I know so much. I know, you see, I don't know whether political parties in Uganda may work. You see, they talk, President Museveni tells us of ideology. But what is ideology in Africa or in Uganda? When you go to UK, you'll see conservative, what does it stand for? They tell you. Labour, what does it stand for? Distinctive, whatever. But in Uganda, we want roads, we want hospitals, we want medicine, we want schools, we want. Eh? And I can assure you, there is no party which comes out and says that for us. He talks of ideology, but me, I don't know what is ideology. In Uganda here, who doesn't want unity? Who doesn't want lack of sectarianism? Who doesn't want schools to develop? We want the same thing. So even if it could be maybe the way we want to arrive at it. But we are very different from the other countries who developed and grew political parties. And I want to believe that political parties start and grow. And that's why you find that they are different in what they want. But for us, whether it is Inup, you will stand up and say, the roads. The hospitals, the same thing, it is like the same thing. And that's why now I say, because when you look back, even when we started independence, was it Kabaka Yeka, which eventually merged with UPC, and they were against DP. And I want to tell you that by the time Amin took over, I think everybody had crossed to UPC except two people. So the Kabaka Yeka, of course, I don't know, it had gone, they had joined UPC. So in the end, that means the parties were not even there. And when even in 1980, DP had won, and then there was UPC. But by that time, even again, they were overthrown by Izito Okero, whatever. I think the members of DP, some of them had been killed, others had crossed, others. So I wonder as to whether we are in a certain level of growth where our democracy must be run through political parties. Because one thing I want to tell you, don't jump in quickly, because when you call us here, it is not about just talking. I think we are educating the public. Because what did I want to say? When I want to tell you, and this is my belief, I've never been a politician in a multi-party democracy. For me, I was a politician during the NRM, the real National Resistance Movement, not party. And I want to say, if the National Resistance Movement kept to its principles and to why and how it came in my thinking, we would have moved better. It was a kind of political system where all of us would say, I say this tomorrow, still I remain supporting Uganda, not individual, because we are driven by service to Uganda, not a specific individual or fighting against this to be here. So me, generally, I want to say that actually, before we go into details, I want to say that I do not believe that in this country or in general in Africa, we have reached a stage where political parties can be a system of government where the government in sitting is a government and the opposition is a government in waiting, where the government does not see opposition as enemy. Because as long as the party in the government sees the opposition as enemy, they will have to fight. You cannot talk of democratic governance when you are there because the others are enemies. And you know very well, clearly, coming to Uganda now, President Museveni had never wanted political parties to come into existence. And I will tell you, we shall discuss this because I have all the evidence. She used to talk to us. And even on that day when we opened political space for political parties, the principle was to be Jeko. These people, the international community and the Ugandans who want parties, let us just say yes in order to get them off ourselves so that we can consolidate and work against them because they are disturbing us. When we keep them, they can talk. But let us say we have opened, but behind scenes, for us, we know, not that you are saying, yeah, let him be there and we build parties. Because I even discussed this issue at length with President Museveni. When we said, because when we were in CA, yes, and in NRIM, we were saying that NRIM, the National Resistance Movement government, or the movement, is the one which will produce good political parties. Because the original ones had gone astray, had gone bad. Now that we are all together, out of NRIM will be born the good political parties. And I remember talking with President Museveni, reminding him of that, and saying now that the NRIM has birthed or produced two babies. One was the NRIM party and the FDC party. And I said, this is good, because if we have achieved this, then let us now leave these two parties build themselves. I even had a long discussion to tell him, don't fight. I told him, now that it's unfortunate that you have lost the opportunity of handing over power peacefully because you have removed the term limit, may you be at least gain the status of being the founding father of the good political parties in Uganda. This was my discussion with him. And he said, yes, I will let the parties move, FDC. After I had left, I had even traveled to South Africa. What do I hear? He has arrested Besigye and put him in prison. Simani charged him with Simani raping a girl. That's when I said, this guy, after we had talked all that. We shall go in detail, but my basic statement was, I am wondering whether we have reached a stage of having political parties, democratic governance. I don't know whether we have reached there.
Some political analysts have linked these fights to President Museveni's underhand workings, and they actually think that for some time he could be working all this out, these fights that you're saying. Do you think that is a correct analysis?
Is it thinking? Me, I know. I mean, I told you, I have worked with President Museveni. I did work with President Museveni for good 20 years on the political scene. And he's the only one I have ever worked with in politics. And I can assure you, he did not want political parties. And he used to tell us, for me, when you go into your political parties, I'll just go to my rachitura and graze my cows and leave you to cut each other with your pangas. This is his language he used to say, okay? And even on taking away, when he was removing the term limit, we discussed the issue of opening the political space for political parties. And the whole idea was to be Jeko, let us take them off. To be Jeko, but we are not supporting them. And then I want to tell you, me, I talked to him when we were partying. He was calling me, come back, after removing the term limit. I said, no, whom shall I join? He said, when I joined you like this, now you are here, now whom should I join? He said, so whom are you joining? Where are you going? I saying I'm going with my God. But I told him, I'm going as independent. I want to be independent and continue to serve my women.
Doctor, we are due for a short break. We are going to be taking a short break. And then we will come back with these stories.
But I will tell you the most concluding part to tell you that what the analysts are saying is true.
Okay.
When we come back.
So let's come back with Dr. Matembe, and we will also be digging deep to understand what can be done to strengthen these political parties. I will also be having Mr. Timothy Chemonges weighing in on this particular subject. Let's be back.